What's good, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. It's just me, Jenny, where it is what it is, and you get what you get. If you are new to the channel, welcome. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Also, don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you are notified every time that I post a new video. Also, before I finish, go down below and hit that thumbs up button and like this video. Comment if you want to comment. It's all love. It's all appreciated. I thank you guys so much for watching and supporting. Really, really appreciate it. As you can tell by the title, I'm about to do another cooking video. So my last cooking video where I made the quesadillas, a lot of people had a very positive response to it. So I decided I'm gonna do another one. So I'm probably never gonna do like no major meals because that's just a lot of work. I'll leave that to the professional cookers on YouTube. But here you're just gonna get like simple little appetizer things. What I'm about to cook today is empanadas, my favorite. So if you don't know what an empanada is, it's like a little, us black folk, we would call it a beef patty. You can make it with chicken, you can make it with fish. Me, I'm gonna use ground beef today. Some people like to put a lot of different things in theirs. I like to keep mine simple, simple, simple. You know, it's a perfect little appetizer for like get-togethers, like little parties and stuff, like little finger food. I think I made one for, I made some for a Super Bowl party one time. Yeah, so it's perfect for stuff like that. Not too crazy, it's not hard to make, super, super simple, especially how I'm about to do it, because ain't nobody got time to be doing a little extra. I like to keep it simple, you feel me? All right, so without further ado, I'm gonna get into this video. First things first, let's look at what you need to make this meal. If you choose to make yours with ground beef, you will need some ground beef. You need vegetable, you need vegetable oil, definitely. You need these Goya empanadas. It says 10 discos. So it's 10 in here. You need some cheese. I really like mine with the regular cheddar cheese, but I'm gonna mix it up, both of them. And this right here is key. So this is gonna be very important to this meal because this is what's gonna have it popping OD. So a few years ago, I found this recipe actually from an old family friend who made the empanadas. But I think we used to use like regular barbecue sauce in the ground beef. But my friend who used to live next door to me, God rest his soul, Keith, he put me on to the brown sugar barbecue sauce inside of the empanadas. And he made it, and I take, oh my God, I was like, this is key. So, you might not like this flavor, you can use whatever flavor you like. Me, I prefer to use the brown sugar. Oh, so good. So, let's get cooking. We're gonna try to keep this video short and sweet and get right to the point. So I'm gonna put my gloves on this time. I know last time I didn't use it, but my nails are like super, super long and I actually broke one of them. So I think gloves is the best way to go, right? So let's get cooking, baby. So first thing, you're gonna put your ground beef inside. Again, you know, guys, I'm not one of these professional cooks, so bear with me. We're gonna go ahead and dump that in the bowl. Next step, can't forget, preheat that pot. Okay, and this meat you do not have to wash, y'all. I know last time I said you gotta wash your meat. This is ground beef, you're not. Totally humiliated. I thought it was recording all this time and it was not. But this is how it looks after seasoning. I'm just gonna tell you what I put in there real quick. Adobo. Powder. Garlic powder, dash of Mrs. Dash, extra, I like to add Italian seasoning. I like to always add a little bit of extra in the seasoning because I don't want my meat to be bland. It got to have some flavor. Too much though, because then you don't want your meat to be salty. So go ahead and pour your meat inside. Hear that sizzle? Yeah, cooking. Go ahead and let that cook for a little bit. Get that nice and brown. So while your meat is cooking, we're going to go ahead and pour some of this oil into the pot so that the oil gets nice and hot. By the time we're ready to dump the empanadas in, it'll be nice and hot and ready. Okay? Let's go ahead and pour that in. Very careful. Damn, almost half the bottle in. So we want that to get nice and hot. And be careful because you don't want grease popping you all up in the face. So we're going to go ahead and let that get hot. So now what we're going to do next, we are now going to prepare the empanadas so that once the meat is ready, we could put the meat inside. I have one open already. This is how they will look. They have white ones also. I don't really care for the white ones, so I use the yellow. So you're gonna go ahead and fit as many as you possibly can in the pan. Which is not many. I can only fit three, as you can see. Oh, look like Mickey Mouse. Huh? The meat is nice and brown. Try and drain your meat before adding the barbecue sauce, just because you don't want the meat all watery and stuff. Yep, one bottle's good enough. I think the oil is popping and ready. Nice. sugar. Ew, can I get that? Now keep in mind the first one is always going to come out the most oily. But as you continue to cook, it's oily.
Jeez, boy.
You know, it's not the proper tool that I usually flip it with.
You know? Girl.
So, you know. Be alright. Let that sizzle for a little bit. Get back to this one.
Get back to it so I can take a break. Mysterious cook.
Mm-hmm. That be me.
Chill, because then they all gonna be in my DM.
Like, yo.
Now that they're finished frying. What you want to do is try to put
good old plastic bag, paper bag.
Try to put a paper bag, a clean one obviously, in a pan so that it will soak up all that oil when you put it inside. So it's just gonna hold it. And keep in mind the first one is always a little rough looking, so.
The third batch is always the right batch.
This is how it should look. You're gonna place it in your pan. Oops. See, it's dripping a lot of oil.
Okay, and you're
keep going. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the final product. Unfortunately, it is time for our pan to go. So they look a little beat up right now because they were getting stuck to the damn pan. But they still won't taste good either way.
Alright, so now it's all done. Mm-hmm. This is now the moment of truth. I'm going to take a bite out of time and see how it tastes.
Ding. Bon appetit.
Ha ha.
Mm. Oh Lord. Takes me back.
Mm-hmm. That shit is still slap.
Oh God, that word. Mm. This shit slap.
Let's slap again.
This is good.
Mmm. Stay inside. My mom's gonna get that much cheese. I made that one. She made this one.
Mm-hmm. It's hot. Mm-hmm. So I hope you try this at home. If you are underage, make sure you get a parent to help you at home. Do not touch that stove or anything, knives, anything on your own. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this cooking video.
As much as we did.
Yes, I enjoyed eating it. Not so much cooking it because I'm just off work and I'm a little bit tired. But yeah, that was fun and it tastes really, really good. So please try it at home. Comment down below if you have your own way of how you like to make it. Like I said, there's many different ways you can make empanadas. As you see, my way is the quick and simple way. But if you have a different way, please do share down below. Comment. Maybe we could try it.
It's not my belly. Hmm? It's my sweater.
Oh, God. But yeah, so as always, thank you guys for watching. Jenny is out. Peace to you. I love that show. This is all. All right, I'm out.